Gauls, I'd rather drop you off here. There are so many customs inspections in Tyre. If I dock up with you two on board, they might hit me with a tourist tax.
Is the city far from here?
You'll be there in no time. It's a Menhir's throwaway.
Sounds like a plan. Let's go. We'll need to keep our eyes peeled, Obelix. If we come into sight, we'll be game for a fight.
Thank you. I'm not, because I fell into it when I was little, and blah, blah, blah.
Here are the famous gates of Tyre, Obelix. All we need to do is slip through the Roman garrison and we'll be in the city at last.
I don't know if it's a trick of the sun, but these Romans look nicely baked to me. Over to you, Asterix! Thank you.
What? We're still in the water?
I won! It's payback time! It took us so long to open the gate to Tyre. Do you think it'll take us all night to find the shard, Asterix?
Before we find the shard, we'll need to find the Temple of Baal first, Obelix.
Approach, ghouls! Come closer! Ah, how fabulous! It's been years since I last had any new disciples.
Come and worship the almighty Bel, guardian of fire.
I don't understand any of this Bell and Guardian business, Asterix.
All I know is that this is no game, Obelix. Getafix was deadly serious when he told us about the legends.
Getafix? You know my old friend Getafix?
Know him? He sent us here.
I see. And unfortunately, I think I might know why you came.
While Asterix recounts the tale of Avena Gandir and the Crystal Menhir, we thought you might like a quick tour of the temple. Travel is always so much more enriching when you add a little culture into the mix. Ah, it'll have to wait. It looks like our hero has already finished explaining the situation.
It's as I've always said. Caesar may be an emperor, but he's a bore too. Kidnapping a woman to conquer a country? What kind of backward times are we living in? Avena Gandir is a friend. She entrusted me with the Shard of Fire, and now I'm entrusting it to you. But be careful. With this shard, the Schnaffel Elga Yokel will become even more powerful.
Thank you, Razzle Dazzlers. Might you know where we can find the last shard?
The missing piece was given to a wise man, a Greek who lives in Crete.
What's his name?
I can't remember. But I believe he lives as a recluse at the top of a mountain. He should still be there.
A mountain? What mountain?
My men here's telling me it can raise me up so I could stand on mountains.
Watch out, Obelix!
The Menhir's powers are something to behold, but we're way too conspicuous with it.
Fire starters out after curfew must be stamped out. You, Princess of Bell, halt!
Razzle Dazzlers, do you know where we can hide?
Yes, a friend of mine will hide you, but she lives down one of those dark streets over there.
No problem. My men here will light up the way.
Obelix.
I'm coming.
There they are! Show no mercy!
Give me that menhir. It'll help me dazzle Caesar.
Marcus Ginantonicus, you again?
Yep, I've been following you since faraway Thule. Don't think I'll let you slip away now.
You know this Roman?
Yes, he's an old acquaintance. A big fan of Gaulish courtesy. Let me show you.
I'm too tired for that.
Stay away! Stay away!
This time it's my turn, Asterix.
By all means, Obelix.
Thank you, Gauls.
Thank you, Razzle-Dazzleus, for giving us the Shard of Fire.
Hurry along to the market. Good luck on your quest. And may Bell protect you.
Goodbye, Razzle-Dazzleus. Come on, Obelix. Economic crisis must be waiting for us at the port.
May Bell protect you. My men here's what'll protect us. Asterix, I'm hot.
I'd started worrying you'd gone a bit quiet, Obelix.
Over to you, Asterix.
My palms are all slippery in this heat. Don't drop the Menhir, Obelix.
Don't worry. I'm the sort that holds on to the bitter end. Over to you, Asterix!
Over to you, Obelix!
Over to you, Asterix! Oh. Asterix, are we going to have time to buy some souvenirs?
Huh?
Over to you, Asterix!
Over to you, Obelix!
Over to you, Asterix!
Over to you, Obelix!
Hey!
Siegfried, red eye clear.
Oh, look, Asterix. It's economic crisis.
My friends, how happy I am to see you again.
Us two, economic crisis. Happy you're here, especially since you still owe us another two free trips.
You are savvy barterers indeed, Gauls. The problem is, we're stuck in the port. The Romans have drawn up their giant chain, blocking exiting boats to stop you from escaping.
A chain? They haven't invented the wheel. But they've come up with a chain.
The Romans didn't invent it. This is pure Tyre made. It's a local chain.
Roman, Tyrian, whatever. This chain is a pain.
The lever they use to operate the chain is in a Roman camp on the other side of the port. But watch out, Gauls. The Roman troops here are on another level.
Come on, Obelix. We've got to find a way of getting rid of the chain. Economic crisis, don't move. We'll be back.
And if anyone asks economic crisis, say we've gone that way, and we're part of a chain gang.
Obelix, what is it now? You never stop complaining.
I'm hungry.
Don't worry, we'll soon head off to an inn.
Over to you, Asterix.
Over to you, Obelix.
To you, Asterix. Asterix is allowed to drop a
Thank you, Gauls. But don't leave yet. I need your help.
Help? Unfortunately, we're in a bit of a rush. We've got work to do.
Listen, my name's Stance. Resistance. I am the leader of the Phoenician Resistance.
Tell us what we can do for you, Resistance.
The Romans are destroying our most beautiful Phoenician buildings and replacing them with their hideous ones. Yet another way of chaining us down. We've got to stop them.
I'm sorry to bother you, but all their constructs are really weighing on me.
We'll help you, Resistance, if you help us get our revenge.
Consider it a deal, Gauls. Come by my place and climb up to the rooftops to get through the Roman site.
Let's go, Obelix. These Tyreans are very welcoming.
It's the little things that make all the difference. over to you, Asterix.
I don't have enough energy for that.
The gloves are here! Come together!
I don't have enough energy for that.
Hey.
And I'm not, because I fell into it when I was little, and blah, blah, blah. I like hot countries. The Romans are crispier.
I don't have enough energy for that. Isn't the time to be making a splash?
Over to you, Asterix! I won! It's payback time!
The chain isn't blocking the port anymore! Economic Crisis's boat is free to leave!
A chain to stop boats from passing through? The things they come up with. Hey, Asterix?
Economic Crisis, we have good news! We've opened up the port!
Wonderful news!
Yes, now you can take us to Crete!
So now I'll have to close my store for yet another free I mean, complimentary trip.
Don't worry, economic crisis. We'll be quick.
And soon you'll be back in Tyre.
In that case, let's get a move on. Time is money.
And to put it poetically, so Asterix, Obelix and Dogmatix set sail for free on a journey without risk, a voyage without storm, without rain nor sleet, all the way to beautiful Crete.